We gotta wait. What?
Try to press the accelerator next time.
You shut up. Okay, I thought it was a racing game. Not complain. Chase Hollywood stunt driver. Let's start with number one. The Unchaseables. Okay. Single completed, finish with 10 seconds left. Hit all four markers, destroy two vehicles. A lot. Okay. Race through the city towards the train station while avoiding gangster ambushes. Oh.
Action!
Action! Okay, here we go. Get to grab these as well. Which way? Oh. Well, we need to destroy two vehicles, right? So. Oh! Well. Jump. Need to stop. Two cars, it was two cars that need to be destroyed. Okay, stop. The fuck? The brakes didn't work. Wow, that was a very disappointing jump. Yeah, not as spectacular as it should be, I think.
Ah, that's a wrap.
Alright, scene goal completed, 500, finish with 10 seconds left. We didn't finish with 10 seconds left. I think. Alright. Next one. What the hell is this? Single complete, finish with 30 seconds left, hit all 3 markers, destroy 5 telephone booths, destroy 3 vehicles, drive on 2 wheels for 10 meters. A little demanding, isn't it? Well, if the hell's the movie. We needed to destroy vehicles as well. Okay, I missed that. So I was thinking, on the PS2 you had the Stuntman game. This is on Xbox. Stuntman came out on the 6th of September 2002. This game came out on the 20th of September 2002. Very close together. Coincidence? Perhaps. Okay. Scene goal complete, finish with 5 seconds left, hit all 5 markers, perform 2 barrel rolls, jump 10 meters in the air. Yeah, how else would you jump? Exceed 130 kilometers an hour for 5 seconds. Sure, beat the train to the station in order to stop the heist.
And action!
Yep. to be fair, this is a bit easier than the stuntman game on the PS2. It's more open-ended, I think. And if you have certain markers and everything. Jump! I want to hit a camera, man. I missed the marker. Yay! Wall. Yeah, we're dead. We're dead.
That's a wrap.
Nope. We're fine. So, no battle rules. We need 3,000 reputation points. Oh, we need 300 more. Okay, so I got the other points. Let's go to scene 4. Triggerman. Okay. Jeez. Finish with 60 seconds left. Hit all 6 markers. Destroy 30 hedges. Break 2 parts from your car. Power slide for 20 meters. Bump evading vehicles 5 times. Okay. Destroy the rival gangster vehicle before it time runs.
Action!
Oh, we have a partner now. You gotta wait. What?
Try to press the accelerator next time.
You shall. Come on, shoot it. We're almost there.
Oh, that one's still there.
come on, it was so close.
Take four. Oh, they're actually counting as well.
Shooting is faster, so we just let our body shoot it.
Instead of ramming it, I think.
It seems quicker, I don't know.
Yeah, it definitely is.
Those were the four scenes of this chapter. 5,000 reputation points. I'll be right back.
Many hours later.
Okay, here we are. Chase of the Triad 4. Warehouse escape. Finish with 20 seconds left. Hit all 14 markers. Break 3 parts from your car. Power slide for 40 meters. Perform 2 barrel rolls. Jump 20 meters in the air and exceed 100 kilometers an hour for 10 seconds. I can't promise anything.
Roll bill.
I see a lot of markers. Luckily we go around. How do you remember the location of all these markers? That's a wrap. How much did we do? Nothing. Okay, let's try the challenge mode. Jump challenge with a go-kart. Let's go. This is not a go-kart, but... Okay, let's time this better. Now, go. One boss? So how many things that we can do? We're at 4 now. I think 6. I think we can do 6. That was close. 8. I don't know. Easy. Let's go for 9. Oh, waiting for that catastrophic crash. Oh, there we go. Jump failed, really? I think this is our limit. I went too early. So this was Chase Hollywood Stunt Driver for the Xbox. The game reminds me of Stuntman for the PS2, which we established just came out a couple of weeks earlier, which is bonkers. I enjoyed it. See you next time. Bye bye.